Hi guys, welcome aboard SelfCAD. Please give me a few minutes and I'll show you why SelfCAD is used and loved by thousands of makers and hundreds of schools. The SelfCAD interface looks nice and clean, yet it can really pack a punch. And it can accomplish much more than many frighteningly looking traditional 3D modeling applications. SelfCAD is designed with the aim of simplifying 3D modeling for the masses, starting from the simple to the most advanced and professional design use cases. Your time is important to me, so I'm going to use slides to quickly showcase some of the best features in each category and provide a video link on each slide so you can see it in action. Starting with basic shapes, you can drag and drop to create new shapes or click on it to create a custom shape, and SelfCAD has the best tools to position shapes relative to other objects in the scene. SelfCAD has also more advanced shapes, and in this example, you can see how you can create a beautiful vase using SelfCAD's unique shape generator tool. SelfCAD has an intuitive way for selecting parts of an object and has the tools to hollow objects. In this example, you can see how to create an ice cream cone with wall thickness in just a few simple steps. In this example, you can see how to color and to add texture. For more advanced use cases, can also add lighting and shadows, and SelfCAD will soon add rendering as well. One of the most elementary ways of modeling is using Boolean tools. In Tinkercad, you can only have two options. In SelfCAD, it's called Stitch and Scoop, and as you can see, SelfCAD has all four options. In SelfCAD, you can even create objects from images. In this example, you can see three basic options for converting an image into a 3D mesh. You can also use 2D or 3D drawings to create any custom shape you like. In this example, you can see how easy it is to create such a bicycle using SelfCAD's unique freehand drawing. In freehand drawing, you simply draw the 2D shape and finalize to create the 3D shape. But when it comes to more advanced object creation, you first create a 2D or 3D profile and use them to create advanced shapes. Let me show you some examples. In this example, you can see how to sketch a house and use the fill polygon tool to create a 3D mesh. The parts are created separately, so you can select and delete the windows and add thickness as needed. In this example, you can see how you can simply draw a profile and use it to revolve around 360 degrees or less to create a really nice and complex object. Revolve is very easy to use in SelfCAD and is great when the entire circular direction has the same details. The loft tool is great when you need full control of the circular details, but loft requires to create many profiles. In this example, you can see how this beautiful juicer was created using loft. Follow pad is another great tool. Like many tools in SelfCAD, this is a multi-purpose tool. You can use it to create objects or to extrude along a profile, like in this example. Many design flows require to first create profiles and then trim away parts. In this example, you can see how it's done in SelfCAD and how you can use the multi-purpose pivot tool to automatically create many profiles and then merge and trim to get the final shape. SelfCAD has also unique wrapping and cutting tools. In this example, you can see how to wrap text, use cut with profile to cut the text into the mesh, and then use extrusion to engrave it. Hard surface modeling is another common way of modeling, especially among artists. And as you can guess, SelfCAD excels in this as well. In surface modeling, you care a lot about the topology structure, and that greatly affects the outcome. In this example, you can see how using the bending tool gives different results based on the object's level of details, and how to use resolution tool to add or remove details as needed. In this example, you can see how hard surface modeling techniques are used to create a car. This is a really effective way of modeling, and SelfCAD's unique tools make it much easier to learn and use. In this example, you can see some of SelfCAD's advanced sub-element selection tools and how to take control of what parts of the objects get deformed when using the multi-purpose deformation tools. In this example, you can see how to use drawing on top of objects and to create the needed topology by extruding with macros, and how to use advanced selection and advanced settings in extrusion to create such nice table legs. such a nice shape with very little effort. Some artists prefer to use simple brushes like in Photoshop, and Sculpting gives this flexibility. SelfCAD Sculpting comes with the best brushes and allows using custom images as brushes. In this example, you can see how you can take any shape and modify it using Sculpting, and how to use custom brush, and finally how to use remesh to fix the topology as needed. No 3D modeling application is complete without animation, and in this example, you can see why SelfCAD has the most simplest animation tool on the market. Finally, if you like to 3D print your objects, you no longer need to use other tools to cut the object to fit the print bed and to fix the object so it's printable. And more importantly, no longer need to download another program for slicing. SelfCAD has all included. Finally, you can see how to cut an object into pieces and how to use Magic Fix to make an object printable. In this example, you can see how to select your printer and to use the slicer to get the G-code. I hope you are as excited as I am and you can see why I fell in love with SelfCAD. And I hope you will too. Thanks for watching, and please like, share, and subscribe.